benches set up. I had some people come over to kind of take a look at the bonsai. And so I set them all up on the tables, and it was, you know, 25 degrees, beautiful. And now we're in the 30s. These trees are going to get scorched, especially something like that nice maple up there. So I'm going to bring them all over in here. And this is where I have been keeping them, kind of shaded under this tree to get nice early sun. But let's look at a few of the trees. This is a little juniper. I've given it a hard prune. Not a little juniper, sorry, a little rosemary. I've given it a really hard prune. And it's growing out just beautifully. If anything, a little too vigorous. You know, maybe too much fertilizer. It started as a little whip. So I've had this for 4 years, just from a $5 rosemary. So I recommend doing that. And I've been keeping it inside actually every year. And so I don't know if it'll keep going, but I had two that I put outside to overwinter and they died. And the roots are, from what I gather, quite delicate. And when you look at them, they're fine and they are delicate roots. So something to be thoughtful, mindful of. Spruce, a couple spruce plant trees in there. You know, they're overgrown a bunch, grown out. But it kind of captures some of the alpine feel. They do need a trim. This is a Norway maple. I put it in this container in the spring, and so people that have seen the video will know that. I put it in this big white container, and it's just pushing out. I mean, this is like a second flush of growth, and I didn't do any, this is a second flush of growth, and I didn't do any, which I should have done, which was a defoliation of some sort, just to put the growth interiorly grow. And I just thought, oh, I'll let it grow out, build roots, because I transplanted it all, and took a lot of roots, but it's just, it's rocking. Little juniper, stagana styled this up this spring. Sort of a nursery stock, $25 one. You can see some, I had some browning, some, you know, shedding of old needles, but other than, and I lost this one branch back here. But other than that, it's just, it's looking great. People have seen that this year. This is a nice raft, subalpine fir raft. And this is the beauty, because that will, I can put it back down even more. I'll have more of a windswept with these big trunks moving over even more. And that will just continue the raft even longer. And so it's just rocking. Like, this tree is just, look at all these new buds coming up. Those are all new. So it's loving its new container. This is like a willow of some sort. It's like a local native willow. And so I gotta restyle it and put these all sort of down. And I'll probably be able to do that this anytime really, because it'll just probably push out another flush of growth. Subalpine fir. This was on my collecting video. Not the most recent one, but another one. And so it's had some time to grow and style. Juniper, you know, I'm finding that, you know, you get so motivated at the start. You get so many trees and you style them up and you leave them, and then all of a sudden you got too many. And these junipers, I mean, this just needs a serious trim, style, all kinds of work, but it takes forever. And I've got quite a few of these sort of like instant junipers, instant bonsai from juniper. But I got really lucky with that one, just as far as the trunks and the twin trunk. And here's another nice one. Norway maple, look at that base, just gnarly. And so it just needs to be, you know, shaped like a bonsai. Well, brought back in, interior growth happening. And here's the big juniper. Yeah, it's looking great. And it's just growing out great. It's putting on some juvenile growth. But for the most part, it's producing this, which is nice. It produced, you know, just lots of luscious, thick growth. It's loving the new dirt and the fertilizer and just everything about it. It's just rocking. And so I'm like, look at that. That is just gnarly and awesome. I can't wait to get the live vein and deadwoods separated here. Like, I think this is live. This is all dead. This is another live vein. I'm not sure where it goes, but I can't wait to find that out. That's next year's project. This tree is doing great. Style it up and it's just looking beautiful. I really like this one. And this is a pot that I had made with peat in it. Turfa? Turfus? Not turfus. tufa, maybe, I think they call it, when you put peat in with it, and it's, so it's lighter, but it's not cracking at all. And it's got this really old, you know, patina, dare I say patina, look to it. You know, it's kind of deteriorating a little bit, but it's, I'm really liking it. And it's got these sort of, you know, holes and things, but it's rugged. It's not as refined, obviously, as the smooth cement, but it's, I actually like that container a lot. It's lighter, which is great, but it's, the thing is, it's not cracking. So I might make more kind of like that. There's the hemlock I worked on this spring. It's growing up great. It needs to be trimmed back, but I just love the bark on this. That is amazing. And I had this branch all curved in to kind of block some of this lower branch because it kind of came up, but I don't know what I was thinking really. Yeah, it's looking just great. Let's see, what do we got here? Another Norway maple. People have probably seen this, ones that know my channel, seen me working on this for a bunch of years. I want to say 4 years I collected this. And it had this crazy root spread. And so I was trying to kind of highlight that. It's a bit bizarre. I don't know, maybe this part comes off. And because this like comes up and out, but it's hard for me to get rid of such nice sort of roots. And so but that might be the trick at some point. And I'm not partial defoliating or any sort of defoliation, and so I'm getting kind of long growth. Like, look at that. That's just, I mean, that's no good, right, the whole way. You know, there's a little new growth sort of right under there on that branch, but like, yeah, what do I do, right? How do I get that back budding along there? Because otherwise it's just gonna keep growing out now. But I'm actually quite happy with it. Juniper, been working on. It's slowly developing. It's really too thick. It needs a good trim. Really let it grow this year just to grow roots, because I'm probably gonna transplant into a different container, something a little smaller. But yeah, I love this one. This one's classic. People just seem to love this tree. It's a little overgrown now, so it's not as nice. Another Shimpaku juniper. This one I feel like I did last year at this time, which is really strange. And I transplanted it and did the work on it all in one go. Maybe 2 years ago, 2 years ago. So I'm letting it grow out and it's getting these nice long whips. And so it's starting to fill out with roots, that means, in my mind, and it's starting to push and grow some vigor. And these are really strange. Like, these are just straight. Everything else is twisted and they come up from the bottom. And so these will probably go. There's two of them in here, two sort of dead woods that look a little strange in there right now. But view of the garden, lots and lots of greens. Peas are sort of done. You know, broccoli's shooting up tons. I had gotten a head that was like huge. But this, you know, needs to be harvested. There's obviously lots in here. Tons of tomatoes and pickling cucumbers. You can see a nice beauty cucumber hanging there, ready to be harvested. And I bet you there's a bunch of pickling cucumbers in there too, like that guy. Let's see if you can see that there. Yeah, there. And so I've got jars and jars of these pickled cucumbers and tons of tomatoes ready to, you know, ready to ripen. Pepper back there. Some carrots not doing so good this year. I need some weeding. Ooh, these guys are looking dry. But pumpkin. In there, got some squash forming. Big zucchinis. There's too many zucchinis. I'm gonna have to water that though. That's definitely looking peaked. Some cabbages. Nice cabbages. Nice big cabbage heads. These are broccolis. These get so much shade. Look at that. I think it's just because it's getting so much shade. It's kind of going to flower. I'll be able to harvest that though. Big cab, nice cabbage heads. This is a purple spinach. I just love it. It's huge now. It's not really doing much, but it'll self-seed, and I'll collect some of the seeds. Like, look at this plant, though. I just love this plant. It's got these all become seeds, and it's just spectacular. And it produces these really, I can show you a picture down here. You get them early on, and they have this color, this like fluorescent pink color. It's so amazing. Yeah, some yellow zucchinis, got more tomatoes, green onions, a bunch of chard. Yeah, lettuce is pretty much done. You can see the lettuce just bolts after a while. Some chickens, I got 6 chickens. Yeah, he's looking a little thirsty too. We get lots of eggs. That's for sure.